What should be the mehr in making a marriage? The mehr could be anything. It is not something that the groom has to give the big money or the small money. It does not has to be a money, because when the Sahaba used to come to Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, or the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, I do not have anything to get married. And the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, even if you have the iron ring or you have anything, then they ended up in something with the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam asked him, do you memorize any verses of the Quran? And the Sahaba said yes. So the mehr was that he has to help his wife to memorize the part of the Quran that is a mehr. So now we have come into the society and we have come into the cultural realm, especially in a South Asian countries, where these things have become so much common that the nikah is getting harder and the zina fahash is coming more easy. Because those who are unable to marry, the woman demands so much money, and the man demands so much dowry for women. In the marriage concept in Islam, the woman does not have to pay anything to a man. There is no concept of jahiz, there is no concept of a dowry in Islam. Even instead, the man has to pay something to a woman. Now when we say he has to pay something to a woman, it could be it's like a gift that you're giving to a wife. This is not something, okay, I have like $1,000, I have $10,000, I have $1,000,000 for you. This is not a business deal. This is something like you're building a relation on a base of Quran and based on Sharia, and it has to be based on something, love, respect, trust. This is not based on money, because when things comes into the base of money in those lives, there's too many contradictions, too many conflicts between the husband and wife, and then you come to be aggressive, the wife, and the family matters, and the both families are fighting, things go more worse. So those relations are basically totally on a very simple way, and the based of a sunnah, they have their life are very beautiful. Like for an example, if you like someone and you can propose someone, you can just simply say, this is what I can give you if you accept that. But if that sister is very nice and she follows the Sharia and she is not a greedy for money, she would not ask that, because the only greedy woman does that, and also the greedy men expect their woman to bring something, and also the greedy woman, they expect their man to pay them something to get married. But why would they have to pay the woman to live with them? I mean, they can go anywhere, they can find any woman to do that. Why they have to get married and pay a big investment on that? So the marriage is not something based on money and how much the mehr you're paying. It is not how much, it is how much respect you think. Because I have seen, I came across the families where the girl and the boy side, they ask each other, the only thing we expect is a love and the respect and the honor of a husband or the wife. This is what we expect, and we do not expect the money or anything. And trust me, these are the only families who has a beautiful, peaceful life in living on the earth, and also they will have a beautiful life in their eternal, because they do not expect, because they do not have the greed in their heart of the money that the husband will be paid that, and the husband does not have a greed, the girl is going to be bringing home this jewelry and these diamonds and this money. Their niyyah should be very pure without any intentions of money. The mehr is nothing but a gift that you give to wife. It could be even a flower, it could be a Quran, it could be anything, something make it very simple. Because those women who are greedy and those men are greedy, mostly they have too much problems in their life, because they did not have a pure niyyah, they did not have a pure intentions. And basically we have to have a concept of the mehr is something like our love and the respect and the care, and something, a gift for your wife. It could be in any form of it could be a money, it could be anything. Like, now let's go back and look at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how did he resolve the problem of a man? And when they ended up that, like, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked the Sahabiya, your mahar from your husband will be that he will help you to memorize some ayah of the Quran. This was the mahar. And we do not live into that society, and nobody follows that, and everybody's into money. The woman, they expect the men to get the money, and the men expect from a woman to get the big dowry, and she's gonna bring something, a big jewelry and the big furniture, big TV, VCR, car, bike, anything. And now the men, they are like so shameless, they're expecting the woman to bring all these things. And on the woman's side, she's expecting this guy is going to give her like a big mehar, and the mehar is gonna go to her family. This is what the business going on in India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, in Arab countries, everywhere. The culture is corrupting. Whoever is getting away from the Islam, their life is getting miserable, and they are removing their peace because they have the greed in their heart and how to get the money from the boy. And the boy has the greed of how to get the money and the jewelry and all these things from the girl side. But mostly the question is about a mahar. So I would ask the sisters, please leave this topic of mahar. Do not expect the money. Rather, you expect in your life that your husband should love you, should respect you, care about you, give you honor of a wife, give you honor of a mother. Later on, he has to care about you and give you love, respect, care, and do not be proud or the cheating on her back, because this was the mahar. And every like a good woman, every good sister, every sister who does not have a greed, this is what they demand from their husband, that I do not expect the money from you, and I expect you to just love me, respect me, and just care about me and be with me. This is the sign of a good woman who has a taqwa in there. Those who does not have a taqwa, they have a greed in them that I'm going to be getting a lot of money from my husband, and this will be my mahar, and this is my right to get a mahar. This is not your right. Your right is to get the respect, to care, and the husband should not bother you whole life. He should not be abusive. He should not be disturbing you mentally or any ways, and live a peaceful life.